Guys, the stage show Lion King have invited me to go behind the scenes and like see what they do and see how they do everything, which is amazing because I've actually been to see the stage show twice, like in London, and now they're coming to Manchester and they've invited little old me out to see how they do everything, so let's go. And my makeup probably looks absolutely insane on this camera because I'm used to an iPhone camera. But yeah, let's just hope it doesn't look whack because the video might not make it. This is my outfit. I thought I'd go with something like cute, but like chic, but also like, you know, we're going out for lunch first. So, you know, it's fine.
I had to stop for a coffee first because I've literally not had anything to eat or to drink this morning, and I will literally get the worst caffeine headache if I don't have coffee, so yeah, coffee first. Guys, when I tell you it is torrentially raining, like not even like a little bit, like it's full on fucking shower sheets of rain, and I've got to get out of the car. And you know what, I have set spray on, I have like setting spray on, but fuck me, I am gonna look like a drowned rat.
So when I finally got to Manchester, I had to check that I didn't actually invite like a drowned rat, and we had some lunch at Refuge, which was nice. And then we headed over to the theater where they had a really intimate setup, like there was only a few of us, and yeah, just listen, it was amazing.
Runs and then she hits the wall and then she almost gives up, and then she that's when she digs deeper spiritually, and that's where I guess that's where we see Rafiki, that's where Rafiki comes in, that's where we see Nala grow spiritually, and yes. it's beautiful.
So I must go.
Their costumes are very intricate, of course, as you can see from these photographs. But this is a Nala mask that she would wear on her head, obviously. And Simba's got one as well. And so it's another type of the puppet. It's not technically puppets, obviously it's mask work, but there's so many different variations of the puppetry and mask work in the show. Why don't you tell us how that adds to your character, or is different than doing a role typically as just a person?
Yeah, the masks are fascinating. I think it really changes so much about your physicality. The first time I wore the Simba mask was in my final round for auditions for the show, so I could sing the song and do the scenes, and then I had to do it again, and they were like, well, just before you do, we're gonna put this mask on you, and it's this big, you know, like this, but it's got a big kind of mane that comes out. And at the moment that you put it on, you have to kind of lengthen your spine, you have to straighten, you know, bring your chest out, and if you don't wear it, it kind of wears you, so you really have to kind of find a way to bring it into yourself. And then as we've got into rehearsals, Julie, the director, has come up with this kind of style of movement, this kind of dancey movement style that comes from Balinese dance movement, so it's very kind of fluid, and you start to move and you almost use your head as the neck of the mask, so you become kind of used to this feeling of kind of moving with this part of you that's another sort of enhanced version of yourself. And then eventually you get to the point, you start with, like, God, I can't imagine getting this and feeling comfortable, but then eventually you get to the point where you're moving like that without the mask on, right? Yeah, exactly. You're like, hey, how are you doing?
He's one of the more complicated puppets in the show. It's sort of like, trying to ride a bike, really. There's lots of different triggers on this guy. So in my right hand here, I'm able to make him blink by pulling this trigger down. I can also make him look surprised by sending him up. lots of expression there with his eyes. He can be very, very tired, very alert. The other trigger here operates his mouth. So there's lots of lip syncing during the show. So he's very, very active all the time. Yes. A wonderful slinky style neck, so you can do lots of fun things there.
There's magic everywhere, and with all this romantic atmosphere, disaster's in the air.
One of the best things I've ever experienced. Like, the singing was just amazing. Like, I can't even tell you, like, obviously I've watched it on stage show twice and it's amazing then, but to actually just have them like there in the room with you singing, their voices are insane. Also, the cast was so nice. They were so sweet, like asking me what my name was. I'm like, I'm a no one. I was like asking loads of questions because I'm just, you know, a weirdo like that, but honestly, the funnest day ever. They give us some like little goodie bags as well, which was so cute. Am I gonna take this to the gym? Yeah, I am. I am gonna take it to the gym because Lion King has always been my favorite Disney film and literally the best stage show I've ever seen. My best friend knew this was coming to the Manchester Theatre before I even knew, and usually I have to travel out to London to see like amazing shows like this. But more and more coming up to Manchester, so I was like, oh, if she was like messaged me saying, oh my God, Lion King is coming to Manchester, will you go and watch it with me? And I was like, yeah, definitely. And then I got invited to this and I'm like, oh my God, like I got to see, and literally there just singing. So yeah, amazing. Thank you so much for inviting me. So guys, in true fangirl style, I'm gonna go watch the film because now I'm just, it's in my head, eat my little cupcake. I'm probably gonna feel guilty for after eating, but you know what, fuck it. And then also just live my life, live my Lion King life right now.